Welcome back to the channel. This video is on minerals, and in particular, we're looking at what makes a mineral fluorescent. We're going to discuss the term fluorescence. We're going to discuss what's in the mineral to make it become fluorescent. To start, let's begin with the term fluorescence. Now, it's a type of luminescence, which is when a material, in this case a mineral, is emitting light, which is radiation, and it doesn't require any additional heat. If the heat is given off, which creates the color or visible light radiation that you can perceive, that is something different, and that's called incandescence, like a candle. But this fluorescence, or this luminescence, does not require or give off heat. It's actually in regards to the material being cold. So fluorescence is when a certain material, which is cold, is exposed to certain wavelengths of radiation. Now, wavelength is the distance between the crest of the energy wavelength as it's passing through a material. And the smaller the wavelength, the stronger the radiation. The larger the wavelength, the less powerful the radiation. So there is a difference between the wavelength. Now, the wavelength that the material is exposed to is in the ultraviolet range of wavelength, which is below around 400 nanometers or 400 nm in wavelength. And this is beyond our scope of our human eyes being able to detect this type of light. So it's beyond the purple or violet in the color spectrum, which goes from 400 to 700 or 780 nanometers, which is what we can see is visible. So ultraviolet is beyond the purple, and when you expose this ultraviolet radiation to a mineral that is fluorescent, it's going to re-emit and push out light or visible light. So when a mineral is exposed to ultraviolet radiation, any radiation or wavelength that's below 400 nanometers, you get it in two types. There is long wave, which is just below the violet visible light color of 364 nanometers, or there is the more intense shortwave radiation of ultraviolet, which is around 254 nanometers. Now, you can have either wavelength, but shortwave has a more effective result of showing the fluorescence in certain minerals. And to get this UV radiation, you're actually going to send an electrical current through mercury vapor gas, which then gives off the ultraviolet radiation, which is actually pretty cool. So we know what the term fluorescent means. Now, in regards to minerals, there are around 5,000 identified minerals. And of those 5,000, around 500 have some level of fluorescent quality or fluorescence. The most common is fluorite, which is the first one to be seen to have fluorescence back in 1852. Another common one is calcite. Now, what happens when these minerals are exposed to ultraviolet light is quite complicated in terms of geochemistry and how the elements and atoms and the electrons are going to react when they are exposed to this ultraviolet radiation. This high wavelength energy or radiation is going to create a reaction within the mineral, within the elements, which forces the electrons between the orbital shells, thus releasing the energy. And this energy is released back out as visible light when exposed or under the ultraviolet conditions. That is basically fluorescence of a mineral. So these minerals can look a different color in regular light. That's between 400 and 780 nanometers. But when you expose that mineral to radiation or light that's below 400, which is in the ultraviolet range, then you get a different color being pushed out or emitted by that mineral. So within the mineral, you need to have certain elements that will enable this energy to be pushed back out and fluorescence to be activated. So these elements that are very good at this in the mineral are called activators. Minerals such as manganese, chromium, ferric iron 3, lead, and dysprosium. And if the mineral has a ratio or different amount of these activators, these elements within the mineral, it is more than likely going to have some level of fluorescence. as opposed to the majority of other minerals, the 90% of all minerals that do not have any fluorescence, they're going to have an amount of elements that are not activators, and these are called quenchers. Now, elements such as iron and nickel and Cu, which is copper. Now, these are all metallic elements. So the iron-free minerals are going to be more than likely fluorescent. And here we have two fluorescent minerals. They're both calcite, but they give off different colors based on them having different elements in the mineral. So on the left, we have this beautiful green and red fluorescence caused mostly by zinc producing the green color. And on the right, we have this beautiful red, which is caused by the manganese element in the calcite reacting with the ultraviolet light. So you have these different elements, but within the same mineral reacting with UV radiation differently, and it's absolutely amazing.